Hi, I am Victoria Guisen Carvajal.
I am Francisca Saez Agurto. I'm the cinematographer of
Hector, and I director of the short film.
We invite you to watch the movie, and we hope you have fun.
Hi, my name is Jan-Felix Wuttig and welcome to the 33rd Teddy Award. I'm here with director Victoria Guisen Carvajal and cinematographer Francisca Sael, and we're going to talk about the movie Hector. Hi, I'm pleased to meet you.
Hi, pleased to meet you too.
Hope you enjoy the festival so far.
Yeah,
and a lot. Well, I got to tell you, I liked the movie a lot, and I found that it was not only very captivating in terms of content, it was also visually very stunning. And you have all these images of rocks and seaweed, of water. Could you tell me a little bit more about the role that nature plays in the movie?
Oh. Bueno, la naturaleza ocupa un rol central en esta película. Es más, nació la historia nació de un poco con este paisaje.
Nature plays a very central role in the film. The story was born when we saw that rocky, imposing landscape. The sea, the sounds affected Victoria to write this story.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
Y tiene un rol simbólico y dramático, de alguna manera.
It has a symbolic and a dramatic role in the movie.
Okay.
Porque como de su rol simbólico, la naturaleza actúa como signo de lo desconocido, de lo indómito y de lo poderoso.
Nature plays a role, a symbolic role, about the unknown, the untamed, and the
poderoso, powerful.
And the powerful. About the powerful.
Y por otro lado también usamos la naturaleza con un rol dramático, en la medida en que nos sirvió para atomizar, para resumir los sentimientos de los personajes, como funciona como una especie como de narrador omnisciente de los procesos psicológicos de los personajes. Explícalo como tú.
Espérate, ¿puedes repetir la última parte?
Ok, que tiene un rol dramático.
It has a dramatic role.
Porque sirve también como en términos narrativos, sirve para atomizar.
Because in narrative terms, it works to speak about what the characters are feeling in the movie, you know? Vaya a decirlo el género ahora, ¿no?
Bueno. Sí. Y bueno, desde otro lado, que realmente es muy importante. It's a very important. The relationship between the characters with the landscape or with the nature is the same
that they have with their identity and sexuality. Mm-hmm. It's
okay.
Hello.
And I have found that, especially in terms of what the characters express. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's not a much of dialogue in the movie, mm-hmm. and instead you have these very this orchestral mm-hmm. and natural sounds. Could you tell me a little bit more about what made you use that very organic soundscape for the movie?
¿Quieres contar tú?
No, dale tú. Sí,
pero en español, perfecto.
No, pero dale tú.
Bueno, de la misma manera en que la naturaleza ocupa un lugar central, the sound of nature, it's equal important. And y quizás y bueno, y de alguna manera nosotros pensamos los sonidos de la naturaleza o los sonidos de la película en general de manera en que cada vez que se pierde algo de realismo es porque está focalizado en el personaje principal, en el turco, el Gabriel.
Ok, ¿cómo empezó?
No importa, pero di que en realidad que el sonido está pensado de forma...
The sounds are when the sounds stop being so realistic and start to being more...
Se pierde, cuando pierde realismo.
Yeah, when it sí, when it... Cuando pierde... espera. when the... ¿Puedes repetir esa parte de nuevo?
Sí, es que di que en realidad el sonido marca el ritmo de las escenas.
The sound marks the rhythm of the scenes, and when the sounds start being more
subjective.
Yeah, subjective is because they are focused in
protagonista.
The main character, what is feeling the main character. You know, it's okay. Like it starts like this.
Claro. Yeah. De hecho, hacia el final,
yeah. At the end,
el sonido pertenece a una escena que nunca vemos.
The sound belongs to a scene that we never see, really see. Mm-hmm.
Okay. So the...
Y bueno, y por otro lado, la música es un ejercicio autorreflexivo.
Yeah, the music is an auto self-reflective, no reflexive exercise. Mm-hmm.
Que de alguna manera es una marca de mis propias censuras.
That in some point functions as a mark of Victoria's own censorships.
Censuras. Creo que se dice censuras.
So.
Es una versión libre de una marcha fúnebre.
It's a free version of a funeral march.
Mm-hmm.
Que es tenebrosa, es trágica, es religiosa.
It's tragic, it's religious, and it's very dark.
Okay. Yes. So in a way, it portrays that darkness, but also that religiousness and the inner life of the characters.
Yeah.
Okay. Sí. Huh? O sea, es una forma de reconocer el miedo que yo o nosotros tenemos. O sea, es como una forma de reconocer también.
It's a way of recognize the
el temor.
The fear that
ante lo desconocido.
The fear
o indefinido.
That we sometimes have about for the unknown.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And concerning that unknown, there's a lot of myth that is talked about in the movie. very early on, you have the main characters talking about the myth of the devil in the cave. What was your idea behind giving the character Hector that almost mythological status?
el diablo es una figura muy importante dentro de la película.
The devil is a very important figure in the movie.
Si uno mira las representaciones occidentales de la figura del diablo,
if we look at the occidental representation of the devil,
nos damos cuenta que siempre es una combinación de seres.
We realize that it's always a combination of beings.
Entre animales y animales, animales humanoides.
Animals, humans,
genitales.
Same gender in one figure.
Todos los genitales.
All the genitals in one character.
Yeah.
Y de alguna manera,
at some point,
que el diablo tenga esa combinación da cuenta de que, esto dilo con tus palabras después, da cuenta de que se le atribuye a lo que es inclasificable un estadio monstruoso, se le atribuye lo monstruoso y además algo monstruoso y dañino, malévolo.
That we tend that it's a reflect that we tend to put on the devil's figure that all that we cannot name, all what we are scared of, and that we don't know how to name.
Mm-hmm.
It's like that's
okay. So you feel that we create that figure of the devil to put it away in some sense, so we don't have to concern ourselves with it.
Si tú crees que la figura, si ponemos esta figura del diablo lejos, es para como no tener que preocuparnos como de eso, como
sí, sí, es que sí, creo que en realidad habla sobre el miedo a cuando algo no está definido, no se le puede, o es más difícil ponerle reglas, o no tiene reglas, y eso creo que nos causa miedo.
Yeah, when something it's undefined, it's difficult to put rules on it and to
tiene reglas.
Yeah, it has no rules and
genera miedo.
And that generates fear.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes. And that also the name kind of did the name have any? I mean, it's only mentioned once. Or, well, technically twice.
Yes.
In the movie, does the name Hector have something symbolical to you?
In the mythological point, no, but we think it's very important because in the moment that the character names herself as Hector, all the conflict starts. It's like ¿cómo se dice en inglés? Es como el punto de quiebre.
Break.
It's
point break.
The breaking point of the film.
Yes, yes. I also thought so, that by naming it, all of a sudden it becomes sort of real.
Yeah, yeah.
And it becomes threatening in a sense.
Yes.
Really, yeah. I thought also that concerning the dynamic between El Turco and Hector, it seems that both have some relationship to water, in the sense that we see El Turco being very close to the water with his face in the beginning, and also later on when all his buddies and himself are by the seaside and they all go, jump in, don't just look at the water, and he doesn't want to, he's kind of scared. Whereas Hector seems to belong to the water, it seems to be the element of the character.
Yeah.
Does water have some metaphorical aspect in that sense?
Sí, o sea, como dijimos antes, la naturaleza o la relación de los personajes con la naturaleza determina de alguna manera la relación que ellos tienen con su propia identidad, con su sexualidad, con el deseo.
Yes, as we say before, the relationship that the characters have with nature, it's very important and defines what they are feeling and how they feel about their identity and their sexuality. We can relate El Turco's sexuality and identity with the rock. It's more structured, and then Hector has a more fluid vision of the gender and their her identity, his identity.
Okay. Yeah.
Sí, y como claro, lo que está diciendo que en esa relación Hector mantiene una relación tan estrecha con la naturaleza, Hector, que se confunden, son un poco lo mismo.
Yeah, Hector has a very close relation to nature and sometimes they
same.
They match. Mm-hmm. Yes. I don't know.
Okay, yeah.
That's okay. Words.
I completely understood. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Great.
In that sense, well, there's fire at the end of the movie. Does that have a certain significance? Because that would be after land and water, that would be kind of a new element, sort of developing out of land and water kind of coming together? Or
O sea, no lo pensamos de forma metafórica ni simbólica.
We didn't think it as a metaphorical or symbolic element.
Pero creo que fue más intuitivo.
I think it was more intuitive.
Como la necesidad de que aparezca algo nuevo.
The necessity that something new appears in the film, at the end of the film.
Yes.
Yo creo que el fuego genera eso, pide eso.
I believe that fires asked for that kind of.
Yes, yes. It makes a lot of sense to be like
claro.
At the end of the movie.
Obviamente que eso luego se asimila con la figura del diablo.
It's obvious that later that we can assimilate fire with the figure of the devil. Mm-hmm.
Pero no lo pensamos
but
en términos de elementos.
It was not thought.
Yes. It was just intuitive, kind of, in that sense.
Let's put some fire.
Yeah.
Sí.
Okay. And concerning that end scene with the fire, I felt that was sort of ironic in a way, because all of a sudden we feel, at least I felt, sort of threatened by that pack of boys, you know, like that group of boys who are looking in the dark for the devil and standing by the fire with shadows over their faces. Whereas beforehand it was the devil that was, or the in a sense, the figure of Hector that was threatening. Would you say that this threat at the end of the movie is somehow representative of a threat to non-gender conforming people in Chile?
No creemos, o no necesariamente es la misma lectura que nosotros hicimos.
We don't believe it's the same lecture that we made when we made the film.
Lo que está muy bien.
Well, it's very okay. Very nice that you have other lectures.
Yes.
Pero creo que lo importante, o sea, creo que nos gustaría más que la película se lea como una especie como de metáfora de una situación social en Chile.
We would like that the
que no se lea.
That ¿cómo fue?
Que más que como una metáfora.
Okay.
De la situación social en Chile.
Okay, more than a metaphor of the social situation in Chile.
creemos que, creo que el aporte a la discusión sobre la identidad, las identidades.
We think that we need to. ¿Cómo se dice aportar?
El aporte. Pero no importa, di como lo que se entrega, lo que da. Lo
ah,
que
we what we can give to the discussion.
About identity.
About identity and gender.
Es más sobre los estereotipos.
It's more about stereotypes
que usamos en el cine.
That we use in films.
Y que los otros lo leen de esa manera.
And the people, the
espectadores.
The, sí.
Que todos entendemos.
And that the public and all we understand like threatening or
creo que la importancia radica en
I believe that the importance
en que aún un personaje que es indefinido cuando aparece en una película creemos
that we still think that when an undefined character appears
todos sabemos que es vulnerable.
We all know that he is going to be the person that it's going to be bullied and vulnerable, I don't know.
Vulnerable?
Yeah, vulnerable. Mm-hmm.
Y de la misma manera cuando vemos a cuatro hombres borrachos en la noche.
And the same way when we watch four drunk men at night.
Todos sabemos que son una amenaza.
We all know that they are threatening.
Creo que esos estereotipos que todos entendemos.
That stereotypes that we all understand.
Hablan de algo, de un sentido común.
Talks about a common sense.
Que actúa en.
That acts.
Hace muchos años a través del tiempo y a través del espacio
in all of us through history, you know, something like that.
Okay. That's okay. Yes. Well, thank you very much. That was really great. I actually took a lot away from that movie, especially that figure of the devil. I thought it was very, very interestingly portrayed, and it has a lot to say. And especially about, you know, the way we portray identity, the way we also take things from certain images of how we are able to portray our inner lives, in a sense. Yes, well, thank you very much for the talk.
You're welcome, and sorry for
I think this was really great. It was
okay.
Really beautiful. Okay. Thank you very much.